Good morning, designers. Now that you're done sketching your possible logo ideas and you've decided on the one that you like, you're ready to start trying to create your logo in Illustrator. So you need to start by opening up the template that you've saved already. Remember, we've already identified our three maximum colors that you're going to be using for this. So we're going to pretty much just ignore all of this stuff. We're going to focus on this artboard today. So you're going to start by clicking on this. You're going to notice it says six different versions of your logo. Just delete that. Okay. So before we can get six different versions of our logo, we got to start by trying to create one of these things. So as a reminder, you should be using your three colors that you have chosen for your logo. Today is going to be a very short review of the basic shape tools, the pen tool, the shape builder tool, and then how do you edit those to create your logo. Now there are some other tools in here, but you should be able to create your logo with these basic tools. So as a reminder, you have your basic rectangle, rounded rectangle, ellipse, polygon, star tool. You have your pen tool. You also have the type tool if you want to do single letters as part of your design. And you also do have that shape builder tool. So quick review. You start. I'm going to start first by... I'm going to start first by making sure my blue is saved because I don't see it in here. So we're using our three colors. You can create basic shapes, advanced complex shapes by using your shape builder tool. And remember, it does not matter what your colors are preset as. I can use that shape builder tool holding down Alt to subtract. So that's how I can kind of make custom complex shapes. So it's all about thinking like kind of smarter, like how are you going to do this? Again, I'm just doing a quick review here. I can also add I can edit too, so you're seeing me kind of edit, so I'm making a weird complex shape here. With that shape builder tool, if I hold down shift, it adds. Remember, again, I can alter. That's kind of the easiest way is to kind of get what you want and then alter it. I can do both adding and subtracting, obviously. I've got some lag in my computer here today. So now I'm getting really kind of fancy here. So you can make some pretty complex shapes, right? Beyond that, you have your pen tool. Again, I'm just reviewing here, guys. So remember, with your pen tool, if I click, that creates straight paths. If I click and drag, it's going to create curves, and I can also do a combination of straight and curved. So it's just a matter of trying to figure out how do I do this? How do I combine these tools to give me what I want? So you very well may need to ask for help. You may need to call me over and I'd be like, well, I'd use this tool, and this tool. This would be the easiest, right? All right, so you're gonna take your time, you're gonna build your logo. But let's say I've decided, okay, this is what I was trying to do. This is pretty good, I'm happy with it. From here, you're going to make some copies. You've got one good one. We're not done playing as designers. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna select that and you're gonna make a bunch of copies by holding down Alt. Now remember, it said at the beginning of the hour here when I pulled this template up that you have to have a minimum of six. I would say, I would actually try to do like nine if you can. Do more than is necessary because the more you have, the more you can play. So now from here, what you're gonna do is, like I said, you're gonna play. So maybe you'll change the colors. Like what happens if I apply a stroke or what happens if I do change the shape a little bit? Maybe I pull that in and I overlap this and I change that color. So what you're doing is you're taking what you started with and you're doing some kind of variations. You're playing around a little bit more. What happens if I close it in? What happens if I completely rotate it and flip it the other way? How does that feel? Does it feel different now that I've done that? What happens if I change the scale and size? So I make my box smaller. How does that feel in relation? Maybe I'm going to make this a little wider. So you're going to do this through all your different copies. And then when you are happy, then what you're going to do is you are going to pick your favorite out of these. You've continued to experiment. You will delete this top section here where it says insert logo, down here at the bottom one. Insert logo only. You're gonna get rid of that. You're gonna find whichever one you like the best. So I'm gonna say this is the one I like. I'm gonna make another copy. And then I'm just gonna resize it so that it fits in the box. To remember, to resize without distorting, you have to hold down that shift key. All right, and that's as far as you're going to get, because then we're going to go on to the next step, which is talking about logo type, but you'll have more instruction before you do that. All right, you're going to have plenty of days to play. Remember, playing is your friend as a designer. You need to experiment. You need to try different things. It's not uncommon for a lot of students to use the artboard or the space out here and make a bunch of copies even over here. What I would say is when you are done, make sure you do try to unline these, make it look a little bit organized. Any excess ones that are out here, kind of delete. I would just fill this with like your favorites, because what it's doing is it's showing me that you are experimenting as a designer, that you didn't just make one and you were done, right? Because I guarantee most of you, even though you already started sketching, you ended up picking one that was not your original idea already. And then from here, I guarantee that you probably will pick one of the ones that the reiterations or the variations that you created. That's part of the design process. That's really common that happens. All right. Otherwise, have some fun, designers, and let's keep branding.